With my first daughter, I breastfed her for 2 to 3 years because that's something that my mother said I should do. I did it. But honestly, that made it worse for me. It made me feel more like I was a milk cow, like my body didn't belong to myself even after pregnancy. So, you and I are both big nerds, and I knew you were the one when we had a 4-hour-long phone conversation. We were talking about video games, and you asked what my favorite video game was, and I said, Zelda, OG. And you said, I'm gonna marry you. And I think that was like a month or two into it.
I just thought this is somebody I think I want to spend the rest of my life with. And I probably knew a lot quicker than a month into it, but...
When you know, you know. And we actually ended up getting engaged after being together for 3 months. And we've been married for 8 years now.
Yeah.
I think I got pregnant about 6 months after we got married. Unfortunately, we had a miscarriage. We lost our twins. And then in, say, a year and a half later, we got pregnant with our oldest daughter, Serena.
I've always wanted 2 kids, and so I wanted them to be closer in age so they could play together and, you know, kind of grow up together and be close. And then we had our son, Atlas, and he was a beautiful, crazy little boy.
He's
full of energy, and I personally feel that, you know, they're reincarnations of our twins. That,
yeah. As much as I wanted to bring our kids into this world, and I knew, you know, what had to be done, I'm a very independent person, and there were days when it felt like my body was not my own, and for lack of a better word, that there was like a parasite in me that was changing my body. You know, there were just days I would wake up and look in the mirror and be like, these aren't my moves. This isn't where these stretch marks come from. And it felt like it was foreign to me watching it change. And I did try to see the light in that, you know, oh, it's a beautiful change. The stretch marks are tiger marks or all that stuff that they say, but it didn't work. And it really did damage to my self-esteem. Whenever I started going through puberty, it was right around the time when everybody, all the models in the magazines, all the celebrities, all the role models for kids my age were stick thin. And I felt like there was something wrong with my body. And then when I finally felt beautiful, and you really helped that, you made me feel beautiful. Like every part of me was perfect. And I finally got used to that, and that's when I got pregnant, and I felt it changing all over again, and it felt like going through puberty again, and, you know, turning into something that I wasn't used to and having to get used to all over again.
It was hard for me because I didn't have to go through that, so, but seeing you go through that, it kind of hurt, and I wished that I could do something or help in some way, so I thought I'd try to help as much as I could and make it as easy as possible.
When I was nearing the last month of my pregnancy with Atlas, I remember I was so excited to start working out, to like get back down to my pre-baby weight. But after I gave birth to him, I was put on an antidepressant that made me balloon up. I think I gained 60 pounds in 6 months. And during that time, I kind of played with the idea. Like everyone thinks about like, oh, I wish I could get a tummy tuck, or I wish I could do this. So I played around with that idea, but after I'd say a year of trying really hard to lose that weight and it just not working, and then the stress and the medicine adding on top of it, I felt like when I tried, it just got worse. And after that, I started feeling a little bit desperate, and I started looking at having procedures done. Initially, I was just looking at a tummy tuck because that was my biggest insecurity. I had the diastasrectomy, and it was separated. My abdomen I had a lot of fat on my stomach that would not go away. And that was my biggest thing I wanted to get done, and a boob job because I had breastfed for years and they were destroyed. I think I told you the same day that I was looking at this stuff to get done. I spent an entire day just immersed in it, looking at costs, looking at the benefit of it, and also really trying to convince you to get on the same page, looking as like, hey, you'll have this brand new body.
well, when you first approached me about it all, I thought it was not needed. I think, you know, I thought you were beautiful. I thought you were amazing. I thought you were perfect the way you were. And, you know, if you weren't happy, then we could, you know, go about it a more natural way. But I could see how much it was eating at you and how much problems you were having and how depressed you were over it all. And it was something that you were struggling with. And it seemed like nothing else was going to work for you. And so it took a while, but we had to do a lot more research and a lot more figuring out on what the actual process of it all was before I was finally comfortable with it, I guess.
I ended up getting a breast lift with implants, a tummy tuck, liposuction, and a BBL all at once. It was a lot.
Yeah. It was only supposed to be one, maybe two things. And and I'd finally kind of grown accustomed to those, and that was okay. And, you know, I felt safe with those, but then you kept adding things, and it was pretty scary for me. And there was a little part of me that was kind of thinking, you know, if something did happen, you know, all this for what? Just to, you know, feel prettier or whatever it is, or feel more confident, you know. But
honestly, I felt stupid and selfish going into it after seeing how risky it was. I did have a lot of times where I second guessed myself, and I was like, what are people going to think of you for risking your life just to feel prettier? But I kind of rationalized it because I realized how much happier it would make me. And as much grief as it's given me and depression as it's caused me, I knew that if I didn't do that, I would probably struggle the rest of my life with really bad self-esteem and depression. And I knew that ultimately it was worth it.
When I first saw you come out, it kind of scared me a little bit, just because you were very much a lot of pain, and you were pretty drugged up on pain medicine, and so you were kind of out of it.
I don't know, where did this come from?
It was definitely a eye-opening for what these next few weeks were going to be.
You were very supportive. I think I was out for about 8 weeks to where I couldn't really do anything. Because of all the areas I had work done on, it was impossible for me to sit, and I couldn't lay on my stomach or my side. Of course, it was really hard not to be able to pick up my children and play with them, and for them to not really understand why I couldn't pick them up, for them just to walk up to me and want to sit in my lap and not be able to explain to them why they can't sit on my lap.
Well, before you went into it all, I thought you were gorgeous. Of course. After the healing and everything was kind of starting to come off, and you could kind of see your body, your new body, I could see that you were gradually being happier and happier about it and more confident and just feeling more back to yourself, like you had control. And I think that it gradually made me happier, made me, you know, see that it was bringing you happiness and that it wasn't all for nothing or just for, you know, selfish reasons, because it was actually helping us together, because you being happier was making us happier, and you didn't have to battle that by yourself, because I thought you were beautiful to begin with, but you didn't feel it, and that was the big issue.
I would not change anything. This is exactly what I wanted, and I don't regret it at all, because I do feel like what I was wanting out of this is exactly what I got, which was a second chance. Now I felt like I could look back on where I was before I had children. And back then, I thought that I was ugly. I thought that I was fat. I didn't love my body. But now, being able to look back and say, oh my God, I wish I looked now like I did back then, and I hated the way I looked. So for me, the surgery kind of felt like a second chance to start over with a clean slate and give my body the love that it deserved from the beginning. My confidence is through the roof, and I feel beautiful, and I feel happy. It's done wonders for my happiness. So, yeah, I think we spent about $17,000 to $20,000.
Well, I'd pay $1 million for you to be happy. There is no price too much for you. But it was a lot of money.